Good afternoon to everybody at Parshat Vaadotcha. Describes finally the trek to Eretz Yisrael, and I seen it towards the promised land. So there was already complaints, and it's very interesting that when you look at the parasha, there's two groups of people who are actually in the same type of circumstances, and they actually totally and completely opposite to one another. And what are the two groups that I'm speaking about? The Torah speaks about the one group, or let's start off with what is common to these two groups. The two groups are find themselves in a position where they can accept the status quo, and yet both of them don't want to accept the status quo and they want something more. And of course, I'm referring to, let's start with the one, the negative one. You have a group of people who have got enough, they've got enough resources, they've got enough food, and they've got a very special type of food called the man. That's the status quo at the moment in the Midbar, in the desert. And what they want is they want something more. They know that there's nice steaks out there. They know that there's delicious type of foods. They're correct in their imagination. They can reconstruct, and when they get the man, they can have the flavor of that of whatever food they want. But they want the, in inverted commas, the real thing. They want to see. They want to be more material, they want to be more physical, so they're not accepting the situation as it is now. It's not so bad. They've got something to eat. They have a different type of flavor. We're speaking about over here now, only after the first year since they went out of Mitzrayim, but they crave to have the type of food that they had once before. They want something extra, the food that they had in Mitzrayim. So that's the one group. Then you've got another group who are in a similar situation. They, for whatever reason, there's a group that have become tamei, they've become impure, and now, in the second year, just before them going to Eretz Yisrael, they find themselves in a situation that they can't, because of their tumah, because of their impurity, they can't bring a korban pesach. Now, the problem, it's not such a problem because they didn't do any avera, they didn't do any sin. They people who, what they did was they found themselves impure for whatever reason. So they've got 100% exemption. No one's coming to them with any demands. Moshe doesn't say, well, you know, you have to do something extra now. They've got an exemption. They can't bring the Korban Pesach. It's like someone being in hospital on Pesach. So what do you want him to do? He can't bring a Korban Pesach. So it's fine. Everything's okay. That's the status quo at the moment. And they're exempt. And lo and behold, these people, what they do is they don't want the status quo. What they do is they come imploring to Moshe Rabbeinu, but we want to do a mitzvah. We don't want to be out. We don't want to be someone who's like sort of separate from bringing a Korban Pesach, which is symbolic of the covenant that HaKadosh Baruch has made with the Jewish people. So correct, technically what we do is we exempt and there's not a problem, but we don't want it. We want more. And we want to have this joy. We want to have this upliftment of being part of Am Yisrael in bringing this Korban Pesach. And there you have it. You had one group of people who have got everything, and they are crying because they haven't got more meat, because things aren't like comfortable enough for them. And then you've got another group of people who are exempt of doing mitzvot. There's no problem. And they're crying that HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Moshe Rabbeinu, give us a chance to be more attached, to do more mitzvot, to be more uplifted. These are the two opposite groups that we are. So I want to tell you something. I went to bar mitzvah, a family bar mitzvah about 2 days ago. And I was discussing when one of the family members of you know, the quandary that we found ourselves, the different type of people that and the parties and what's going to be, etc. So the one person said to me, you know what, leave all the politicians alone. The fact is that I'm not getting into it. Just leave the politicians. The fact is that Am Yisrael, that the vast majority of the Jewish people, besides extremes on this side and extreme on that side, they love the Jewish people. They love the Torah. They've got only positive, and they've got to. They're prepared to do everything for the Jewish people, not like the Meshugoyim from I don't want to mention their names, but people who like sympathize the whole time with Hamas. We don't have to go into everything that the Jewish people is a provocation of the Arabs, etc. I'm not going, but the majority of the people are not like that. And he tells me a story. So this is a story that happened a month ago. There's a friend. We went to a chasana, and the chasan was a person who is from a very, very elite force, fighting force in the Israeli army. And in this elite fighting force, they've got like basically a couple of plugot. They make up more or less like 45 people in this very, very elite squad, which is made up of, at a given time, 45 people, sort of two groups of more or less 20-odd. And these people, because they've been in elite squad, very special people, you have to add on to the 3 years of service, they've basically been with one another for 5 years. And the bonding is just absolutely incredible. So when one of them got married, so actually, now let's listen to this. So what they did was, they all went basically to the chasana. But the problem is now, you've got a small band of people. They made up of 45 people. So who's going to take their place if everyone goes to the chasana? You know what they did? They arranged that their colleagues from previous years who've just like finished the army, that those 45 people will be called up for Miluim for the two days. Can you imagine that? Do you see what bonding of Am Yisrael is? Do you see over here what people can do? 45 people are called up, and they do it willingly on reserve duty, so that the other 45 people can participate in a chasana of their fellow fighter. Pashut, it's unbelievable. So with all that goes on, right, you see, there are always those type of people in Am Yisrael. There's those type of people in Am Yisrael who they've got everything. We've got a Medina, we've got Lachman, and now they want to look a little bit better. Let's have a little bit of a steak. When it comes now, let's have peace and quiet. We'll just give everything to the Hamas, or like in the Hebrew University. So I saw that someone who's got a doctorate in Hebrew University, and what he does is he helps in medical school. So on his Facebook account, he responded to someone who's saying, you know what, let's all pray for the Jews to be killed, all that there shouldn't be one which is left. And he said, amen. And then the cowards from Hebrew University, so they said, well, you know what, when they heard about it, we're not doing anything. I mean, so this done was done outside of the Hebrew University. Let the Lord deal with it. It's not something to us. Okay, so you got those people. We're not going to shift anything. We're not going to make a noise. When it comes to Jews, we're not getting involved. And then there's type of people. You know what? We'll go to Miluim. We'll leave our job. We'll go now to help our fellow soldiers who now one of them is celebrating a wedding. We want everyone then who is now currently with them that we should all be Sameach. We'll go to Miluim so that everyone can be Sameach. There's this group and this group. There's people who wanted to, as I said, they couldn't take off the manna. And then there's type of people, for them it wasn't enough. And then there's people who want a challenge. They want a challenge to give and to grow and to do greater for Klal Yisrael. And those people, they're the people who said, we want Pesach Sheni. Yes, we are exempt, but we don't want to be exempt. That's how it always was in Klal Yisrael. And most of the people, Baruch Hashem, they belong to the people of who want Pesach Sheni, who always want to do basically love good with Klal Yisrael and to grow through Torah and be attached to Hashem. So yeah, Shabbat Shalom lekulam.